When we were going to bed, the president of the Philippines, Rodrigo Duterte, was waking up to a populace with a temper that would even make him blush. I should remind you, the viewer, there is no entitlements for the poor or working class in the Philippines. What they fish, they eat. What they don't eat, they sell. What they buy often gets washed away in the many typhoons they have during the rainy season. Clearly, they understand the difference between a typhoon and a bad deal. The protesters certainly were not going to watch their generation get washed away by China. A group of about 1,000 unsettled Filipino protesters descended on the Chinese embassy in Manila to oppose the Asian superpower's growing sway in the Philippines, and as tensions rise over Beijing's presence in the disputed South China Sea, Filipino flag-waving marchers chanted China out and brandished a banner saying defend our sovereign right, referring to Beijing's expansive claim to the resource-rich waterway. The government headed by President Duterte is not responding. What China is doing is almost an invasion, marcher Alex L., 53-year-old teacher, told AFP. However, the president has repeatedly said war with China would be futile, and no one has intention of getting into a conflict with the rising power he has courted for trade and investment. Argentina is one of China's main trading partners in South America. The trade between both countries amounting to nearly $13 billion in U.S. currency. Before 2008, the amount of exports Argentina sent to China accounted to be $5.79 billion, and imports from China to Argentina totaled $7.6 billion. Deficits emerge in Chinese trade, although in this rare situation, China was not charged for the 10 to 30 rounds of 40mm L-70 DP gun expended on Chinese fishing vessels, or exported by Argentina's Coast Guard free of charge. This has not hurt the trade between Argentina and China, and no reports of any new illegal incursions into Argentina's exclusive economic zone has occurred. Since Argentina recently sunk a Chinese fishing vessel for the same illegal acts in March 2016. All right, that's military.com. I'll go ahead and leave a link. And this is exactly how Duterte should do it. Forget the military on military action. Deal with the actual issue. It's going to be food. Thanks for joining me on The Curve.